tonight at the GMAT conference for this award. I started or graduated from Tribeca Nesbitt University and became a school teacher. I taught sixth grade for 30 years and enjoyed that immensely. My wife, who was working at Tribeca, said, you know, there's a position opening at Tribeca working with freshman college students in developmental math. And so I thought about it, decided to take it, and began working with students that needed help with remedial math before they could take a college level math class. That kind of led into, as one day I kind of looked at the catalog of Tribeca and I noticed my name there and a new title. I was now not coordinator of developmental math, but I became coordinator of retention. And I went to my superior and said, what's with the new title? Well, you just got a new job. You've got to keep your old job, but you're going to get to keep a new job. So I began working with helping students be retained at Tribeca, and that job would relate to student athletes, and began working with our coaches and with our students and helping them to be able to continue their academic success at Tribeca. About 5 years ago, Coach Jamie came to me and said, Jeff, would you like a new challenge? Would you like to become the academic mentor for the volleyball team? I always loved new challenges my whole life. I've loved to do different things. I said, sure, I'd be glad to. One of the first things I did was went into the roster and looked at the students that were there, began looking, and I noticed, okay, there's an OH, an MB, an S, and a DS, and something called a libero. Okay, I've got to find out what all these things are. The learning curve was going to have to take place. And so I began to initiate myself into the program, learning different things. I remember in a game, I was sitting close by the Jamie, and she said they were going to run a 5-1 offense. And I said, 5-1 offense. Okay, there's five players, one player makes six players. That makes sense. Okay. And then a little bit later, she said, we may have to go to the 6-2. And I said, 6-2? What do you mean? That'd be eight players in the court. You can't do that. The learning curve continued to develop with me as I began to learn various aspects of being a part of this team. But as I worked through that, I realized I was coming to the games, I was helping them with the academics, I was doing all the little things, but I wasn't really, for me, getting close to the players. And so I made a decision to invest my time not only in their lives academically, but I wanted to invest my time with them at the practice team. So they saw their commitment to coming to practice at 6 o'clock, 2 and 3 or 4 times a week, that I could be there too, to see their development, to see their progress, so that I could do a better job working with them on a day-to-day basis. I just want to say thank you, Jamie, for all that you did for me and helped me become a better person, a better individual that helped students to succeed. Thank you.